If you have been recently prescribed a biologic medication like Humira or adalimumab, Enbrel, Tocilizumab, Xeljanz or Rinvoq for rheumatoid arthritis, here are 10 crucial things that you need to know before starting treatment. I am going to break it down exactly what biologics are, how are they going to work, what are the tests that you need to do before starting them, and we will also talk about what vaccines are needed, if biologics are safe for pregnancy, and if they increase the risk for cancers and heart disease. So basically everything that you should know and be prepared before you start treatment with these powerful drugs. Let's begin.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Diana Girnita, the founder of Rheumatologist OnCall. If you are watching my YouTube channel for some time, you know that I have discussed a lot about rheumatoid arthritis and especially rheumatoid arthritis treatment. But just to refresh the subject a little bit, rheumatoid arthritis treatment usually starts with medications called disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs like methotrexate, hydroxychloroquine, sulfasalazine, or leflunomide. But when patients do not respond to these drugs, or they just respond partially, as a rheumatologist, I am advancing the discussion and I propose the next step in therapy, which is called biologic medications. What are biologics and how do they work? In the 1990s, researchers made a huge step in understanding our immune system. And based on the research done at that time, they identify molecules that create inflammation in the body. And based on that knowledge, the researchers designed the first line of targeted therapy, that it was called biologics, which were supposed to target these molecules that create inflammation and stop that. Biologics are some sort of proteins that we call monoclonal antibodies that will target and neutralize specific molecules like TNF-alpha, IL-6, and many others. Let me give you an example. TNF-alpha is a molecule known to cause inflammation and can be present floating in the blood, in the fluid of the joints, or on the immune system cells. Now, researchers have designed medications like TNF-alpha inhibitors, and I'll give you some examples, Humira or adalimumab or etanercept or Enbrel, that will block the activity of TNF-alpha molecule and in this way will decrease inflammation. Biologics were a huge advance in the therapy of rheumatoid arthritis as they dramatically changed the prognosis of this disease. Yes, biologics have the ability to decrease inflammation, pain, joint pain, but very important, they do not cure the disease. What are the most common biologic medications used in rheumatoid arthritis patients? For patients with rheumatoid arthritis, here are the classes of medications that we currently use. TNF-alpha inhibitors that will inhibit TNF-alpha molecules, and I will give you some examples, adalimumab or Humira, etanercept or Enbrel, golimumab or Simponi, sertolizumab or Cimzia, infliximab or Remicade. Another class, IL-6 inhibitors that will inhibit IL-6 molecules like tocilizumab or Actemra and sarilumab or Kevzara. Another class are CTLA-4 inhibitors. And here we have abatacept or Orencia. Now, JAK inhibitors will act on the nucleus of immune system cells, thus inhibiting the production of multiple proteins that may cause inflammation at the same time. If you want to learn more about each of these, I have them covered extensively in another video where I also present when are they supposed to be used, what are their benefits, and what are their most common side effects. Now, let's discuss in detail or more detail the 10 crucial things that I share and discuss with my patients at Rheumatologist OnCall before we start therapy with biologics. Number one, what lab work or lab tests are needed before starting therapy with biologics? Biologics may lower your immune system, and that can cause reactivation of an old infection, a dormant infection like tuberculosis, hepatitis B, or hepatitis C. All of these infections can become active when your immune system is decreased, so that is why it's important to get tested before you start therapy with biologics. If your doctor finds out that you have a latent infection with tuberculosis or you have hepatitis C, you need to be treated or start on treatment for tuberculosis before you start biologic therapy. Number two, what vaccines are recommended before starting therapy with biologics? Vaccination is essential before starting therapy with biologics, since these medications can potentially decrease your ability to fight an infection. You should get up to date on vaccines to protect you from flu, pneumonia, shingles, and COVID-19 infection. We also know that certain drugs like JAK inhibitors, for example Xeljanz and Rinvoq, may increase your risk to develop shingles. That is why I always recommend to my patients to get the shingles vaccine before they start therapy with JAK inhibitors. Some live vaccines are contraindicated while you take therapy with biologics. So, if you are already taking the biologic therapy, you should check with your doctor if a certain vaccine is appropriate for you or not. Number three, what to do if you develop an infection while you are taking biologics? Now, based on the latest research, the risk of developing infection is higher in the first 6 to 12 months of therapy, especially for TNF-alpha inhibitors. Upper respiratory infections like sinusitis, otitis, bronchitis can happen. There is also an increased risk of shingles, especially in patients taking glucocorticoids along with biologics or JAK inhibitors. Severe infections are rare, but they are possible. If you develop an infection or if you have signs of infection like a rash, redness, pain to the site of the injection, fever, chills, night sweats, or cough, you should stop taking the biologic medication and immediately contact your doctor. Once the infection is treated and completely cleared, you may resume treatment, but only after you discuss with your doctor. Number four, can I use biologic injections or pills? Is there a difference? Simply said, biologics can come as infusions, which is a therapy given via intravenous access, self-injectable when you, the patient, give yourself the injection, or they can come as a pill. Which one is appropriate for you? To answer this question, you would need to discuss with your doctor which type of biologic is more appropriate for your case. I always involve my patients in the discussion as I take in consideration their opinion. Now, some people are afraid to give themselves an injection and they prefer an infusion or a pill. Some people may prefer injections rather than going to the hospital and spending half of their day to get an infusion. However, sometimes the insurance company will decide what type of biologics is approved for the patient. Are pills better than injections? At this time, I can say we don't really know, as most studies do not compare if one biologic is better than the other one, but rather they try to prove that they are all equal, they can replace the previous ones that failed, and they can be an option in those cases where a patient actually fails one class of medication and it may drive the next class in line. Number 5. Can biologics be combined with other medications? Yes, absolutely. They can be combined with DMARDs or disease-modifying anti-rheumatic drugs like methotrexate, leflunomide, hydroxychloroquine, or sulfasalazine, or even with non-steroidal anti-inflammatory medications, for example, ibuprofen, naproxen, meloxicam. But this is very important, as we cannot combine one biologic with another one because there is an increased risk for developing more infections. Number 6. Do you have to stop all other medications when you start biologic therapy? To answer this question, you need to discuss with your doctor before stopping any medication. Generally speaking, you do not have to stop unless your doctor says that you have to stop it or you had a side effect from that medication. Once you feel improved on the biologic medication, then gradually, together with your doctor, you can discuss the decrease in the dose of the additional medication and in time maybe stop it completely. Number 7. Do you have a history of cancer and you start a biologic medication? Or do biologics increase your risk of developing cancers? Now let's talk about these two situations. Number 1, if you have a recent history of cancer, especially in the last 5 years, you need and you should tell your doctor immediately. Some biologics, for example, TNF-alpha inhibitors, are contraindicated in people with a recent history of cancers, especially in the last 5 years. Number 2, let's talk about the risk of cancers with biologics. To this day, there is still an ongoing debate. Some reports suggest an increased risk of developing cancers like lymphoma or skin cancers in people using biologics, while other studies say that carrying a disease like rheumatoid arthritis that is responsible for ongoing inflammation may actually be the cause of your increased risk for cancer anyway. However, the risk of cancer should not stop you from considering therapy with biologics. Every year, you should get a skin cancer screening by a dermatologist as a precaution, as there were some studies suggesting an increased risk for skin cancers in patients treated with TNF-alpha inhibitors. Number 8. Are biologics safe in people with heart disease? Yes, biologics are generally safe in people with heart disease. A special consideration needs to be paid to TNF-alpha inhibitors and JAK inhibitors. Now, patients with heart failure taking TNF-alpha inhibitors rarely, but possibly, may develop new onset or worsening of the heart failure. Patients with a previous history of heart disease, like myocardial infarction or a heart attack, stroke, pulmonary thrombosis, they need to avoid using JAK inhibitors, as there are some reports that will increase the risk of thrombosis in this category of patients. So if you suffer from a cardiac disease, you should disclose this to your physician, who will order a complete cardiac evaluation before you start therapy with biologics. Number 9. Are biologics safe in pregnancy? Now, certain biologics like TNF-alpha inhibitors are considered relatively safe for pregnancy. No risk of adverse maternal or fetal effects were observed following TNF-alpha inhibitors like adalimumab or Humira or sertolizumab or Cimzia exposure during pregnancy. However, the data that we have regarding the use of other biologics is very limited, so it is crucial to contact your physician immediately if you are planning to remain pregnant and discuss therapy options. If you want to learn more, I have another movie about medications that are appropriate in pregnancy. Number 10. How long does it take for biologics to work? This is a common question that I get in my office. As I tell my patients, do not expect that you will feel better overnight. These drugs get into effect gradually, and it's usually going to take 4 to even 6 months to see the effect of these drugs. Many patients will notice a gradual improvement in pain, stiffness, and swelling in just a few weeks or a few months. What biologic medications did you try? What is your experience with these drugs? I want you to share your thoughts in the comments below. If you find this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel to support my educational mission. So, in conclusion, those are the key things that you must keep in mind when starting biologic therapy for your rheumatoid arthritis. Work closely with your rheumatologist to tailor the treatment plan just for you. With the right medication choice, plus lifestyle changes that I always talk here in my channel, it will support your journey with rheumatoid arthritis. Thank you for watching, and I look forward to see you soon.
RheumatologistOnCall.com